I am presenting the Yaroslavl Art Museum with the project of cooperation between our museum and the Yaroslavl Diocese. Let me introduce our museum. Yaroslavl Art Museum was founded in 1919 in ancient town. It is the only art museum in Yaroslavl region specializing in fine arts. Today, the collection of our museum includes more than 75 pieces of art and covers 900 years of artistic history from 13th century till 21st century. The pride of our collection are Yaroslavl School of Icon Painting, finest example of provincial portrait, masterpieces of Russian avant-gardists. Every year, about 150,000 tourists visit our museum. The museum carries out active exhibition policy. The exhibition map of the museum unites over 50 cities of Russia, Spain, Italy, England, and the USA. Part of our museum collection most strongly sought for is the collection of old Russian art. It's considered to be one of the best of Russia, in Russia. It includes more than 2,000 icons and originates mainly from Yaroslavl churches destroyed during the Soviet times. The icons reflect the development of Yaroslavl style in icon paintings. The exposition of the icon is situated in one of the first city stone houses. It is a fine example of civil architecture of the 17th century, where was the residence of the head of the church. This year, our museum had published the full illustrated scientific catalog of this part of the museum collection. The project we are presenting today was prepared by Old Russian Art Department of the museum in collaboration with Yaroslavl Seminary. It's a part of work on actualization of the old Russian art collection and its introduction into social life of modern society. The project was recognized as the best in the International Museum Festival Intermuseum 2013, and it's especially important for us received the ICOM awards. The festival has discovered the Yaroslavl Art Museum to be its only Russian museum that regards seminarians and representatives of Russian Orthodox Church as a museum visitors. Let me ask you a question. Which Russian city had you heard of? Moscow, for example, St. Petersburg, and maybe Sochi after last winter Olympic Games. But our town is older than all of them. It is one of the oldest city, and it has a 1,000-year-old history. From the day of its foundation, it was formed as a center of expansion of Christianity in the northeast of the country. The church played the main role in the life of society, being not only a place of worship, but also a place of social and artistic life. The 17th century is considered to be the golden age of economic, political and ideological development of the city. It was a time of prosperity of trade and craftsmanship. It was a time when city was in the epicenter of political life of the country. In less than a century, several dozens of stone churches were built, hundreds of icons were painted, all of them of a great historical and artistic value. Today, the monuments of the 17th century have become the tourist brand of Yaroslavl and includes on the list of UNESCO World Heritage Sites. Since the 18th century, the direction of the development of the country has changed several times. The formation of secular state decreased the role of religion. The Soviet time deprived the church of most of its property, withdrew it from the social life of the country. Only after the breakup of the Union, the Church starts to acquire the lost position in the ideological life of the state. Restitution of Church prosperity has been legislatively assigned. It has become common to hand over churches to dioceses. Should the churches in Russia belong only to the Church, or it is part of art and has no religion, these questions is subject for discussion. Very often, representatives of Russian Orthodox Church and the part of modern society thinks of the monuments only as objects of worship and consider museums to be the organization which have illegally come into possession of them. An opinion that an icon must be in the church is very common in the media. However, they often forget that museums saved churches and countless pieces of church art from destruction during the Soviet time. And museum experts restored many of them and made them an essential part of Russian culture. The church has started to claim to return pieces of art from museum collection. And now it has become obvious that we need to create a program of collaboration with Yaroslavl Diocese, because this problem with our museum too. Some words about Yaroslavl Diocese. It was founded in the year 991, 3 years after the official Christianization of Rus. In modern Russia, our diocese is the oldest and the biggest. The Bishop Pantelimon is head of the diocese. It's highly respected, has a great influence of the citizens, and is supported by the authorities. It also constantly claims its right on the ancient icons from our museum collection in order to use them for religious purposes. The project of collaboration with the seminary is a part of a big life, our life, big program of cooperation between the museum and the diocese. It has three directions: collaboration with church representatives from churches, monasteries, education of seminarians, and work with the administration of Yaroslavl Diocese. The tradition of our collaboration has a long history. For the first time in 1991, Yaroslavl Art Museum organized the duplication of the icon for an operating temple. It was our offer for church after after diocese claim our icon from our collection. And for the first time in Russia, this situation when we created a copy for diocese was realized. And this practice was continued. In 2009, especially for the 1000-year anniversary of the city, four duplicates of museum works were created for the Cathedral of Yaroslavl. The duplicates were accomplished with the financial support of the Ministry of Culture of Russia. It cost about 2.5 million rubles. In 2013, museum created a duplicate for Kazan Convent. For this copy, we used the money which we had won for this very project. Duplicating means that the original masterpieces stay in the museum collection. Another example of collaboration between our museum and the diocese is the program of conservation of the 14th century icon of Our Mother of Tolga in the Tolga Convent. The possibility of creating a duplicate did not seem possible for the monastery, because the legend says the monastery was founded on the very place where this icon appeared. The discussion about the transfer of the icon began in the 1990s. At first, the icon was taken away from the museum once a year for 3 or 4 days to take part in monastery celebration. But the monastery wanted to have the icon on permanent exposition. The monastery and the museum consulted much on the matters of creating conditions for preservation of the icon in the church. As the work went on, the nuns of the convent understood the necessity of recreating special conditions for protection of the icon. The special security system and climate control system was installed in August of 2003. Since that time, the icon has been there. It is the only icon which is exhibited outside the museum in Tolga Convent. At the same time, this icon still makes a part of the State Museum Fund. The experience of this collaboration between museum and Tolga Convent demonstrated that church representatives usually have no idea about religious art and do not understand the depths of the problem of preservation of historical and artistic monuments. It's become obvious that museum education of churchmen should begin from the early age. And only for this purpose, the Yaroslavl Art Museum elaborated the courses on the history of Yaroslav Diocese and museology. The head of the Old Russian Art Department, Victoria Gorshkova, supervises students' work and carries out the main part of the lessons. First seminarians came in 2011. At first, the students attended only the course of Yaroslav Diocese history, and since 2012, the course of museology. Its course has appeared in the curriculum. There are 50 seminarians and 18 of them attend museology course. The lessons are presented in the form of lectures about works of art of the museum exposition. The lectures cover the history of Russian museum's formation. It's very important. First museum appeared in the 19th century. Many of them were organized by priests who withdrew the most valuable objects of cult from everyday use to save them for future generation. During the time of revolution, objects of cult and religious as it was were prohibited. And it was the museum workers who saved churches and icons from complete destruction. Museum experts have been restoring and saved objects for decades. And now our seminarians can visit the restoration workshop during the studying process. The possibility to see all the museum objects openly allows to understand the important social role of the museum as a keeper of national culture and history. Seminarians take part in museum celebrations, concerts and psalms, visit a new museum exposition. We believe that the education of the seminarians will ensure the museum to get the future priests as a supporters in the act of preservation, exposing and promoting cultural values. And we are sure the collaboration resulted in the fact that Yaroslavl Diocese has refused from 3 religious buildings for our museum purposes. It shows their respect for our museum activity. We believe that this experience will help in preserving our national cultural heritage for future generation. And in the end of my presentation, I would like to show you a short film by our big friend, our artist, Oscar laureate Alexander Petrov, which film was devoted to Yaroslavl.
И плакала млада Марьюшка, плакала, ай, Боже ж мой, плакала, як же мне от девушек отвыкать,
Thank you for your attention. We are very welcome you to Yaroslavl.